Bless him.
Hello. Hi, welcome to Nuclear Throne. Let's play. Think I should pick random? Oh, why not? Oh, wow. Okay, as eyes you have telekinesis, so I can pull through the door, including enemies and bullets. Oh no, wait, bullets I push away, but enemies and objects are pulled towards me. So that's how melee weapons work. Yeah, and I think you sort of get the idea by now. You run around, kill stuff, and then hope you make it. Okay, and then you level up when you've got enough rads over here, so that's radiation points. And then I have to pick what I want. Slower enemy bullets, I like this one. I'm gonna pick that. See in the top right corner, you can see it over here. Okay, that's a little mini boss from my cursor. Or actually it's a boss, it's not a mini boss. So there we go, okay, I've got him now. Okay, we killed them now. And you got different guns. I hope the volume is okay for those people. I put down the volume so much. It still sounds low. On more. Oh, crossbow, that's one of my favorite weapons. It's very strong. Bullets. Oh yeah, and ammo is constantly an issue. Machine gun, no. Oh yes, rather a machine gun than an assault rifle. So the machine gun, the assault rifle, you have to tap, it shoots those, you know, those three at once. The machine gun you can hold it for like a nice gradual shoot. That's nicer, I enjoy that one. Okay, and this crossbow just shoots one bolt, but it's very strong, it does high damage. So there's a couple of abilities I can pick again. These are random, by the way. So what you can select is random. So I'll pick this one. Some kills regenerate ammo, that's a nice one. Or melee range. No, I'll pick this one. Okay, and then I'll use my... This area is usually dark, but because I'm eyes, this is one of his special characteristics. That he can see in the dark. Damn, it's hard to talk while I'm shooting this game. Because it's high pace, you can see I can I'm using telekinesis, right mouse button, I'm pulling the enemies towards me. Because I can see they're hiding from me now. Using my telekinesis. And if you, oh yeah, and as soon as you kill everyone, then the portal opens to the next area. But the portal destroys some stuff, so it's quite dangerous as well. You need to time it right. This toxic bow, it's also like a bow, it uses a different kind of ammo. I just press space bar to swap between. That's the default controls, I think it works quite nicely. The toxic bow shoots like a toxic gloop, but then it makes a cloud of toxin and then it does damage over time, but I don't like that. The crossbow is better than mine. Okay, so here's a couple extra. So this one, yeah, you can read that. Most bullets become ammo, but it only works with bullets. This one, the faster you kill people, your reload time, so that means you can get faster damage in. I think I'm gonna take this one. Corpses fly and hit harder, because if you kill someone, its corpse can fly and damage other things. So I'm gonna pick this one. Alright, so this is the next area. Okay, there's a lot of stuff over here that's trying to kill me. There's that one. I don't know whether that one's dead or not. I'll pull that towards me. There we go. Oh yeah, that's a laser. It's one of those snipers. Be careful with all those. You can't always see them. Sniper is below there. Ah, we're gonna use our telekinesis to draw him out. There we go, got him. Use the car. Up, careful. There we go. There we go. This is a disc gun. It shoots discs that bounce around, but those discs also damage me. This is a splinter gun. It shoots like three at once, like this. And it sounds like a good idea, but I don't know. I sort of prefer the crossbow. But maybe... yeah, I enjoy the crossbow more. It's one shot, it does high damage, it's good for what it's... It's nice to have like a all-rounder weapon and like a sniping weapon as well. Like, so a crossbow with something else, like a machine gun, is actually a really good combination. The mastering of swapping your weapons is key. Oh yeah, and like... Oh, careful for this one, I know he explodes. Take some distance. He also explodes. Got an SMG. I'll pick this SMG. Even though the SMG is very inaccurate, it's very powerful. The SMG does high damage. Okay, was that the last one? No. Select my... Yeah, that was the last one. Go in there. Ooh, I'm going low on health. Okay, yeah, so health upgrades always trump damage upgrades. So this one's just for speed. And this one is if they attack you, it does damage here, but this one is what I want. If I kill people, I get health. That's what I want. Yeah, I saw the laser there. Okay, that's the boss activating. Yeah, you see it? See him in the corner there? That's... His name is Big Dog. I can't see him now, that's why I'm having trouble. There we go, whoa. I'm sure as you've noticed, this is a bouncer SMG. It shoots bullets that bounce. I think it's an upgrade from the SMG, so I'm picking that one up. Whew, that's rough, man. Okay, so see, I always check your ammo and then swap to this one. There we go, we got some more bullets. Next area. This one is the, like the crystal area, this one is quite rough. But because I'm eyes, I can see in the dark over here, so that's gonna help a lot. There's these crystals in this area that's really rough. Okay, not these spider ones, alright. They're alright. Whoa. Whoa, careful. Oh, that one was rough. Wait, what? What's that? No, that's just... Those crystals are what I'm talking about. You see the use of having a sniper there, yeah? Here I'm gonna bounce those in there. Okay, nope. Pull him out. Telekinesis. There's another one there. There we go. Pull the radiation in because I need that. Oh, and that could be an enemy, by the way. This box. There is a mimic, if you know what a mimic is. I'm just gonna check the rest of the stage. Okay. Some chest here that I missed. Okay, so I'm doing okay now. but I'm getting low on my shotguns. Pop rifle is also like a machine gun type thing, but it just bounces around a little bit more. This is a thrown butt. It's a little weird, but yeah, it gives you, depending on your character, it boosts your special abilities. So this one is eyes, so it gives me stronger telekinesis. I'm gonna pick this one instead of stress. Even though stress is quite powerful, I'm gonna pick this one. Okay, my telekinesis, I'm gonna use it to draw him out. Because as soon as those get close, they I'm not sure what's down there. I'm gonna use my telekinesis to draw him out. I'm just gonna shoot some bolts in there. I don't know what's there. See, I told you the crossbow, man. It's a common weapon, but it's a really good weapon. I'm using my telekinesis. Because I want to draw them out. Because what they do is they sort of hide from you. And then they ambush you when you fly. See, I'm using my range. I'm maxing my range as much as possible. Trying to come out now. Because this game is difficult, so... Okay, so you want to be careful. Ah, yeah, and I got health from that. No, oh dear. See, what happened there was... the portal opened up. Be very aware that those cars can blow up. So, if an enemy is around them, you can shoot them to blow them up. But that also means I could also use it for you. Okay. Okay, this is a triple machine gun. Uses bullets, but like three times as much ammo. It shoots in like a spirit formation. Okay, I must say this telekinesis is helping me a lot now. What's this flak cannon? I won't take that because it's like a shotgun thing, but it's not that good. Okay, you see. Oh yeah, and the teleporter can also like explode stuff. So that extra feat thing that I saw. Okay, this is a teleporter. A portal, you can get like crowns here, but I'd rather not mess with this because as soon as you shoot it, then those triple machine gun, as soon as you shoot it, they come like enemies there, it's from the interdimensional police department, and then they kick your ass. Oh shit. Oh, they picked it up. Down at the boss stage now. That guy. Probably one of the most important bosses in this game. Yes! The problem with him is, as I think he's called Little Slugger, he should be. Because as soon as he spawns in 5-3, that thing that... Cause as soon as he spawns, then he lands on top of you, he summons back up, and like he explodes area around him, and he shoots like bouncing bullets as well. He's really difficult to kill. Because even though this killed me, like this fox killed me, as soon as you get there, you have to clear up the area and then kill him, and I keep forgetting. But he's really difficult to get past. But anyway, yeah, let's do some more, because... Oh yeah, because I took random. Now I'm chicken. I don't know, his special ability is a little weird. Because what happens is if they kill you, then you can... you lose your head and you can run around in a little small area. And then if you can pick up a health box or get health back during that time, then you can actually revive. And then his other ability is to throw weapons, like he can throw his sword, for example. like that. But I don't really like it. Like, the weapons are just used better if you just use shoot. Maybe if I have long, arms and and my weapon that I don't pick up. Sometimes it teleports through with you and sometimes it doesn't. I'm not sure how. Okay, I have a laser pistol now. It's strong, but laser ammo is rarer because it gets used up really quickly. Okay, so let's see if we can. See if we can do it this way. Grenade, oh yeah. The grenade launcher is strong, but it shoots and then you have to be careful and remember where the bomb is, because I've killed myself so many times with this weapon. It's ridiculous. Okay, let's see if we can find a melee weapon. See, it is an impact grenade as soon as it hits something, but if you miss, you have to wait for it to explode. And if you don't count how many times you shot, you don't get trapped. No, you'll lose out. Okay. That music is saying that the boss is strong, but I can't see him. I think he's probably stuck somewhere. Or he's down there. Oh yeah, seriously. He took quite some damage. Yeah, I think we'll keep the setup for now. Throws pierce through enemies. Oh, that I can throw my weapons through multiple people. Probably not take that. This is one of a really good one as well. It means more ammo and health drops. That's very useful. Okay, here we go. See, now because I'm not eyes, this is like a dark level. I can only see like a little bit around where I am. So I have to be cautious now. And I don't have telekinesis either, so I can't pull the enemies out. I have to be careful. Oh. That big one spits out more small ones. Oh. Whoa, what? How? There was still an assassin. Oh, I got the bonus stage. That's that music. I have no idea how this bonus stage happens. This one is some kills regenerate ammo. I like that. I'm gonna pick that. But taking my own advice, I think health trumps always. So that means more HP for your kids. I'll take that instead. And we'll swap back to our laser. I don't know what that is. This is like a bonus stage, but I don't really get it. See, if you don't keep track of. No, I don't want to teleport just now. Oh man. Jeez. No. So I'll. Whoa. I'll swap to that. I'll swap to my laser pistol instead. Because that's the sniper off. Off map. Yeah, I have one health. Okay, see, that was an assassin. Oh yeah, they lie down and they pretend to be dead, and then when you get close, they wake up. But they do a ton of melee damage, so it's. Come on, drop health. I have increased drop health, man. Come on, drop health. Drop health. I'm even on low health. Yeah, oh, there it was. There it was down. Better accuracy, most hit bullets become ammo. Better accuracy, probably because I'm low on bullets. Oh snap, see, so in this scenario where I spawn right on next to a car, run away. Wow, man, how many times did I miss that one? Sorry, I probably should have collected that later, but I need the weapon. Need ammo. Ooh. Oh, yeah, this... Ten energy, okay. Let's just shoot that box first to check if it's not a mummy. Because if it attacks you, it takes a lot of health away that you could have saved. So this is double shotgun, that's for... Well, I mean, you can probably imagine what this is. This is a grenade shotgun. Again, you can pick it up if you want to, just explosives are dangerous. I'd rather stay away from it. That's a weapon. Okay, that's a crossbow. Now, I'll stick to what I have for now, and in hope I'll get some more. Okay, so big dog is here. Just be aware of that. There's some area here. I'll explode those. Try and stay away there. The few big things that bother me about those lasers, those people that shoot the snipers, is that they can shoot the bullets through Big Dog. So that's the boss over here. So if he's behind him and he shoots there, I have to dodge both. I think that's just a lightning shotgun. I've never gotten a lightning shotgun before. So then let's pick it up. Okay, so that's what that does. Let's check it out. Again, the laser is probably better because, like I said, you need like a sniping weapon. Those things do a lot of damage. But fortunately with the machine gun, dealt a lot of damage, so... Okay, I think he died, there we go. Okay, so lightning sort of seeks out, it's sort of like auto-aim. And the shotgun shoots a couple of rounds, but they need to be relatively close. Okay, so what I have more of? Energy, so I'm gonna... Wow, okay, are there any chests here? No, it's... Okay, so it's going okay. I'll swap to my machine gun. Yes, Bloodlust is also very good because, again, I get health. Strong Parrot is really cool as well because it prevents death once, recharges at full HP next area, but I'm probably going to get this one. Okay, trying to get rid of the car first. That's a hazard. Try and kill him first. There we go, full HP. Wow. I couldn't see my body. This was where my head was. I think my body was over there. Yeah, he tossed the bloody car in my face, damn it. Yeah, see, so in this area what would have been more useful is like the laser actually instead of the laser shotgun. because, or the lightning shotgun, because the laser has the range. So you need one close range, one long range. That helps. Right? Well, but let's continue. I mean, it's short. Oh, I'm melting out here. Okay, so this guy has like no health, as you can see. But if I right click, I can explode corpses like that. So that's his special. You see. So he can do crazy amounts of damage, but you need to be extra, extra careful because he's so squishy. Oh man. There we go, on the side. Oh. Crossbow, what's this? Yeah, and health. Oh man, like this wouldn't even help because I don't have enough max life. I'm just gonna get like extra feet so that hopefully I can run away better. So I think because I can already explode, let's take the rocket launcher instead. Oh, that was intense. Melting, bigger corpse explosions. So probably taking strong spirit is probably the best idea because it prevents death once, you know, and then it recharges at full HP, so I get one health box and then I can do it again. This gives me bigger corpse explosions. I'm gonna try and live. I'm gonna try and live. Because, yeah, like I said, Malfinix is very, very tricky. Sorry, I'm sort of concentrating, as you can see. Jeez, that man. This game requires it to be damn fast. And yes. More health drops. Okay, so let's go down. Okay, that's that. No, go, go. Wow, these corners, they are really close up. Okay, there's another one. It's gonna explode. I think that was the last one, nope. That should be the last one, nope, still not the last one. Okay, I've definitely killed over here before. That was the last one. Bloodlust, yeah, help. Okay, you can see the little halo around my character, that means strong spirit is on. But it's only gonna work once. See, so these guys see, they're actually alive. Oh, there, I've taken my one. Can only take one more arrow. Hopefully I'll heal. I'll shoot that to make sure. See, that's sniping, man. Ah, there we go. Sometimes your guns get sucked in, sometimes it doesn't, like now it does. I think I'll take it. The double shotgun, a very short range, big spread. Oh, I see. Okay, and see, I sniped the sniper, so he exploded and then helped. Cluster grenade launcher. Well, yeah, that's a cluster grenade launcher. So if you think normal grenade launcher wasn't good enough, then yeah. Yeah, so the damage is enough now. Now they. Interdimensional police report. But now I can go through it if I just want. Then, whoa, it's lucky I didn't get hit there. Okay, so here, higher ammo max. What's this? Boiling veins, no damage from explosions and fire when under 4 health. I like that because I'm always under 4 health. I take that. Okay, so this gives you a... You get to this area and then here you can pick up a crown, which alters your gameplay. So that means either this, a crown of life, no HP drops, big chests, no, they are more common, no ammo drops but more weapon drops, pickups fade faster, worth more, crown of destiny, free mutation, narrow future, a lot more curse chests and more drops when at full HP, less drops when not. I'm gonna pick the crown of risk because I only have 2 HP. So. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I didn't even see how I died there. Oh, I think it was this one. Yeah, so the problem with like big weapons and big explode, like the shotgun that shoots big, is you have trouble keeping track of what's going on. Like what bullets are yours, what bullets are... That's why I like the crossbow very much. It's, and like the laser, so it's very precise and then you know what you kill. And like here, you know, try and go back and forth and so on. But I mean, getting here with melting isn't bad, so... okay, let's try one more time. Oh no, good. Wait, oh no. Oh yeah, this is also one of my favorites. Less enemy HP, so I'm gonna pick that one. So enemies have less health. Okay, the slugger is a shotgun related weapon and shoots like a gun. Assault rifle, you know that one. Strong spirit. I don't know. It should have helped me last time, but I don't think it did. But I'm gonna pick it again because I think it did actually help me. But what happens was the only way to reset it is you have to make it through a stage. It only resets the next stage. It doesn't reset once you get full out. It resets once you get full HP in the next area. So see how they die easier because of scary face. It makes a significant difference. Okay. No damage from explosions and fire. Probably gonna pick up more health. That's actually very lucky that I get those. Yeah, see, strong spirit helped me now. I actually died there. But see, my halo is gone. But I guess you survive on one health. So if I get full health now, I'll have it again next. Whoa. That is actually a flak cannon. That type of damage where it shoots a ball and then splits it. That's a flak cannon. I really need health. Okay, no, that's not the... Oh man, if I got health now, I would've... So it's not gonna reset. Oh dear, what's down here? See, I bounced the ball there, because shotgun slugs bounce. Wow, I didn't actually see him there, whoa. No! Yeah, see, the fire lasted too long, because the sniper's bullet came and I wanted to run away there. These things, their fire is also way too long, because if they're in a position like here or here, it'll burn here and here. But now because it's on the opposite side of the screen and it burns this whole length up until there. Yeah, I think this is something that should be changed. Now I'm kicking again. Okay, okay. I'm not sure of this, but apparently you can hit explosives. I mean, let's check it. Oh yeah, you can. Whoa! So you play baseball bat, but I don't think that's a good idea. Oh yeah, you can hit back bullets though as well. So there are a couple of advantages to melee, but you sort of like need long arms, which increases your melee. Oh. See, I can hit away those. But I think it would have been more useful if they gave him a melee-based ability instead of being able to throw weapons. Like that. Because he used to have the power of slowing down time, which could slow down bullets. But that didn't work well either. But I think being able to throw weapons isn't that useful. Yeah, bullets, laser weapons. I'll just take an extra chest then. Well, the problem is you throw away your weapon. Like, and you need it. You only have two. If I had 10 weapons, then I wouldn't have time. Oh dear. And it doesn't do that much damage, see, that's like four hits. One grenade, see, so... But, on the other hand, I mean, this game has been in production, like, for a very long time, and it's come a long way. It's a lot better than what it was. Like, the new version, it's officially released. Oh, okay, I see. This one takes a lot longer to regenerate, this one. Yeah, I think chicken should rather just have, like, half the time for melee weapons. Because there's no character that specifically is useful for melee weapons. Strong Spirit or Bloodlust? Yeah, no. Bloodlust, that's better. Oh dear. Ow. Oh dear. What happens when I go to the next stage with no health? I'm probably just gonna die. See, my health drops. Oh, but I got health in a box. Oh yes, so see, then I revive. So that's useful, but I think also helping him with melee weapons, like giving him extra range or reach or something. Oh no, there's nothing. Oh, so that was lucky. Oh yeah, you can destroy this with a grenade launcher, so... Well, if you do it right, obviously. There we go. So... That would be... Oh. I see it woke up, but I bashed it into pieces. Oh yeah, and you can slam through walls. Oh! Whoa! That is way too far. Ah, the asshole ran away. Can you believe it? I wanted to kill him and then maybe get health back from Bloodlust. But you can see, like, working with melee is a challenge. It's not so easy. Like, guns are almost obviously more powerful. Except that you get, like, something like an energy hammer and stuff. Oh yeah, here I'm. Okay, I'm harder now. When he gets better choices with mutations, he's slower, but he gets a better variety of choices. Like when he levels up, and he can also shoot like a radiation. Like when you get rad, you can spend that and then shoot like a beam, like that. But then you use up your rads quickly. And doesn't do that much damage in level like the earlier ones. So he's only really good later. But I've only managed to reach the throne with him so far. But it was luck. It was luck. Yeah, it was luck. I mean, you see how the things go. I mean, some runs are better, some runs are worse. Ow! See, he's very slow. I can feel it. Ah! Wow. that's a special kind of scorpion. He doesn't always spawn. See, I've got a better range of choices here. This is really cool because it gives you +4 extra max HP. This one's also really cool because it means it my beam charges up faster. So that means when I shoot my beam, it does more damage. And if I use my beam for longer, I actually heal myself. But I won't pick that because you actually need the early levels. Like, you need this later. I'd rather pick the obvious one. I can just get more health. It's boring, but like, when a game is difficult, you can't really say, oh, let's do something for fun. Like, you want to actually finish. You want to actually get through, so... die. See, I'm glad I took the health now. See, I got nice. Got extra health. There we go. Okay. What's this? Sledgehammer. No, I'm gonna keep my machine gun. What's this? Slower enemy bullets. I regen, and this is get full HP, and lucky shot. More speed. Regenerate ammo. I'd rather take this. Was it sort of to do with like survival? Plasma gun. Oh no. I'll show you how it works now. Okay, let me show you before I finish this one. It shoots a big ball like that, and then it does damage, but it's so sorry. I guess because of there we go, level up. But it's, I don't know. I think it explodes when it gets hit, and I think that explosion can damage you as well. I think so, I'm not sure. Nope, that's still not the last one. Where is the last one? That was the last one. Yep, boring as always, but it works. If it works, it works. Splinter pistol, what I don't have. Shells. Climb over. Yeah, you can climb over carbs if you're like boxed in. But I'd recommend stand a safe distance and then just get rid of them. Alright, yeah, so a plasma gun is on the hard level. Thank you. I think that's actually it for this area. Gee, man, I just got stuck. I keep getting shotgun shots. Okay. Yes, this is what you want now. So, less health for them. So, they die easier, so it's easier. See, I'm not using my plasma a lot because I want to save it. So, that's sort of when you get a good gun, you know, which I realize the plasma gun now is actually quite powerful. Because there are other versions of it that shoot and then explode and then it shoots other pieces that also damage you, which is pretty dangerous. Then you want to save up, like I can see I have a good weapon, so I'm saving that up for. So then I just go to sort of my default weapon. Okay, let's see how it goes. Oh yeah, now we're in the crystal area. Okay, let's see that. Okay, so it looks like what the plasma ball does, it like hits an enemy and then it continues to hit them for a while and then... These spiders rush at you. When they see you, they hide away, and when you get into a small corridor, they rush you, so the shotgun is actually really useful for that. So just make sure that you know exactly what you're fighting. Make sort of like a mental note of that. Okay, so I have that, so I'm gonna exchange that for the triple machine gun. The triple machine gun just chows through ammo much faster. I think the shotgun is better. Okay, see, so now I can either get more medkits. I don't have more medkit drops here, but still, I mean, medkits or the beam that heals me. Or an extra chest. Or extra from medkits. I'll probably take my... because that's cooler. And it might be round about the area. Let's see. Okay, bolts. No, I don't need bolts. And these guys are similar to the spiders, except they're worse. Because if you... Oh no, he died at least. Because if you get close then they hit... Oh yeah, this is the energy hammer that I told you about. Let me just show you too. If you pick it up, then you hit with energy, but then it explodes. You can even destroy like pieces like that. Oh no, 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 but I don't want to take it. Oh, no. Damn it. Okay, so we're at 5-2, so the slugger isn't coming yet. So it can still go slow. Jeez. Okay, so let's just take a check and see. Yeah, see, so this one is a melee but very strong. But it uses energy. Okay, and this is the energy sword, so let me take that. Probably does less damage but can swipe faster, like it reloads faster. Okay, I'm actually impressed. This energy sword is doing very well. I'm gonna... Oh, see, that was the mimic. See, good thing I hit them, right? So that's a good break. Okay, this is the last mutation. Now I'm gonna use I'm gonna be using my beam. But in the next area, I'm probably gonna die. So, because the slugger is coming. So I'll do this for damage. Now, clear up the area as fast as possible. Clear up the area for you to find it. Damn, that one is difficult. Trusty buckshot, man. Flame shotgun. Yes, please. Well, you guessed it. It's a flame version of the gun. If it hits anyone, I mean, we're done. Oh, the web gun is even better. It just shoots, it's like a big shot. No, no, I mean, if you get past that level, you get pretty sick weapons. Like, this is one of the best weapons. I'm sure of it. Like, I haven't gotten further, like even later, like, because you can play this game, loop it, and then do it again. And then you get, when you loop the game, then you get even better weapons, but ish, it's damn hard to get. Okay, so that's the position. Oh yeah, those guys spawn in. See, man. Wow! Now those things are difficult to kill. A blood hammer, hyper rifle. Laser minigun. I'm gonna take the hyper gun, I'm gonna take the laser minigun. Okay, so basically what a blood hammer does, that's a blood hammer. It means that if you, as far as I know, is as long as you hit an enemy, it's fine, it doesn't take... It's a really strong hammer, and as long as you hit something, you don't take damage from it. But, if you don't hit something, then, and this is just a good, it's like an upgrade of the sword, right? But if you don't hit something, it attacks you. Yeah, see, it's like the, maybe I should skip the laser. Max energy, okay. Wow, okay, so these weapons are powerful, but they suck! Oh, Oh dear, I accidentally... I got my weapon back. Bouncer shotgun. No. So hopefully I'm not at the throne yet. I don't have my I do have a laser. What's this? Blast wish. Full HP and some ammo. Oh dear. Max shells. Okay, bazooka and that. Okay, so that last mutation was worth nothing. Oh man. I should have... Yeah, because otherwise I would have had 7 beam. My beam, and that would have helped a lot. So this is the throne, I have to kill it now. It's difficult, man. Okay. Basically it just shoots like a massive beam. It's just very difficult to kill because it has big area damage. But anyway, we'll get to see it. So it's this thing. And then... I believe I have to shoot it to start it. Oh, someone leaves. I wanted to get that, I should have backed off. Yeah, but my problem was that I didn't check my beam. Because how it works is once you level up, you can't use your right-click beam powers anymore. So, because last time I did that and it helped a lot. And, damn it. Okay, so I'm probably going to stop there because that's not enough. I've done enough now. So anyway, but thank you. Thank you for watching, and hope you have a good day. Thanks.
Yo, hello. Yeah, it's me again. Thank you for watching the Nuclear Throne piece that I just played through, because it's long. Yeah, I realized it's long. I just checked that it was an hour. It's quite long. Almost made it. Damn it. I realize now that I should have taken Plutonium Hunger. That would have helped a lot, and that's a piece of advice for you if you're going to play it through. Get Plutonium Hunger like before the end boss, because what I forgot and I couldn't remember, because the first time I fought, I arrived at the throne and killed it for the first time. Then I killed it so quickly, I couldn't remember what was going on. But actually, the bombs that the throne shoots drops health and ammo, and that was my concern. So if I knew that, then Plutonium Hunger would have won, be the one that I picked, and then would have helped me through that. So that's a plus bonus thing to check out. Anyway, thanks for watching. Let me tell you a little bit about the new Nuclear Throne. It just came out. Even though it's been out for a while now, it's out of early access basically. So that means it's officially now released. Vlambeer makes it. They made a couple of other games as well, so you might know them. Luftrausers, I think, is another one of theirs. It's also like, I haven't played that, but okay, it doesn't matter. What's important about this game, what's interesting about it, is a long time ago, when I was still on like TIGSource forums, and I was around on TIGSource a lot, and I was checking out there. It's a long story, but basically it boiled down to that they were free games, like online, right, and I was looking for them. And I don't mean like piracy games, no, I mean like actually 100% free. And I was like, what? There's something like this? And they said, yeah, come over to the independent gaming, you know, source, and then there's a lot of games there. So then I was a while there. I was there for a while. And then they talked about this game called Wasteland Kings. That was Nuclear Throne's name back then. And then I saw the screenshot of like a fish, and then he had a screwdriver and a shotgun. And I saw a little bit of gameplay footage, and I was like, yeah, I mean, come on, you know, I mean, it can't be that good. It can't be that good, because back then it was, I was grinding games like crazy. Because basically there's a lot of, in the independent gaming like community, there's a lot of shovelware, like rubbish that you don't, like games that are supposed to be rubbish, that it's just made for a short period of time, but it's free, like it's freeware, no one really cares about the games, it's maybe just to show off a proof of concept or whatever or so forth. And I thought this game, it's gonna be another attempt, but they're not getting anywhere with it, it's not gonna go anywhere. You know, but people were very positive, like they supported it, and I said, yeah, this is a game to check out. And I was always looking out for a decently goodish game, because among them there were actually pretty decent ones, which were, like I said, it was like completely free for no reason, but it's really good. You know, but this was before, you know, Steam did this whole, you know, like green light business, etc., etc., long before. So it's much easier now, etc., but yeah, I just wanted to mention that this game has come a long way. And it shows. It really does show. And there's like one or two things that I can complain with for, but it's maybe like off-screen enemies are still a little bit rough, and like that blue teleporting boss. I think his name, again, I'm not sure if his name is Little Slugger, but yes, dude, the guy that teleports, and you'll see, he kills me a couple of times. So anyway, yeah, and I just wanted to say that this game has come a really long way, and back then I wasn't really so interested, but wow, man, they polished it out, and it's amazing. It's awesome. Okay, so if you're wondering, like, how long have I played it to you know, to get to that level of skill or whatever? Around about like 13 hours. Yeah, 13 hours. That sounds long because it's such a small game, and you're thinking, oh come on, man, you're not gonna. But it, when you get into it, like Nuclear Throne's frantic pace is insane. It's like, I compare it to the only other thing that I think's pace is worse than that is Geometry Wars. It's like Geometry Wars, which is like that's a compliment. Geometry Wars is like damn intense, but that's also like too much. It's too much, man. Anyway, so Nuclear Throne is, yeah, it's really intense, but it's actually well done. Like you can keep up, you know. And yeah, you die, but I mean you get back into it so fast. I mean, you see, like I go through a couple of lives, and it's really like, oh, it's so intense, and it's so action packed. It's definitely something worth checking out. Like if you're slightly in this zone of twin stick shooters, like I said, maybe if you've played Geometry Wars, especially if you've played Geometry Wars, this is very similar to that. Very intense, very like kill everyone on the screen. And you're trying to look at, you know, like the left side of the screen, the top side of the screen, the bottom side of the screen, the right side of the screen, like in all directions at once. And I even thought that Nuclear Throne would be a really good way to test driver ability. Like, how aware are you of everything around you? Like, if you can't make it to, like, you know, at least if you can't make it to at least like the zone where those wolves are, and the ones that pick up the cars and they throw you the ice, the sort of the ice city metropolitan. If you can't make it to that zone, at least like zone 5, then you fail on your driver's test. And they're like, well, I'm sorry, you can't keep track of what's going on around you. You're a traffic hazard. I'm sorry, then you can't. But if you can, then they're like, oh, fantastic. And for rally drivers, they're like, okay, you have to beat the nuclear, you have to kill the throne twice to see if you're like, okay, if you can actually do rally. Yeah, it's a little joke. I don't know how funny that was. It was funnier when I thought about it when I was playing it, because it's ridiculous. It's like a frantic pace. But I am trying to sponsor the game. The game is, or not sponsor, advertise the game, or encourage buying the game. It's really great. Oh, yes, and that's another thing I wanted to add. If you want to support the game, right, don't buy it on Steam. Buy it on Humble Bundle, like I did, and then get the key from them. Because Humble Bundle means that more money goes towards the developers. That's just a little tip. Oh man, I had a lot of fun, and I did like a few more videos. I think I'm gonna upload them just for the sake of uploading them, and I hope you really enjoy it, man. Thank you for watching and enjoying it with me. I hope you liked it. And check it out if you're in the zone of like, frantic shooters. Thank you. Anyway, goodbye.